in the yard.
Glad to be back.
Oh, I know. Well, I think we should just kick it right off because we're starting with. Yeah.
With Galen all the time because he lives upstairs, but back with Mitch Hebert.
And I know there's somebody missing. Brian's not here.
Sorry. Brian has a rehearsal for Opera House Theater Company's upcoming musical kicking off their summer season of Grease. So that opens July 7th. So go to the Opera House Theater Company website to get your tickets. And the Thalian Hall website, either one. So, we usually
get my guitar.
And can you hear everything okay? Everything's good.
All right,
yep.
So, we usually have a theme.
That started with Brian. Brian likes themes.
So, I decided to keep it going. And our theme really this time is songs that have been stuck in my head or really speaking to me
since last I saw you guys. So that's our theme. So, but this one is one that we all just love to play whenever we have a chance.
And this evening could not be more perfect for little seals and crocs.
Hanging in the window, giving on a Friday night.
But just songs
that I discovered because of listening to the Waylon Jennings. And if you don't know them, I'm not saying Waylon Jennings. I'm saying the Waylon Jennings. And if you don't know them, you should check them out.
They're really awesome, and their harmonies are amazing. Obviously, I will not be harmonizing with myself this evening.
If I could, I'd be and I don't have one of those looper pedals.
Then I could. Anyway, this first one is a song called Heaven When We're Home, and I think truly,
yeah, come on through. Wave to the Facebook people. There is a gate here. What? You didn't know, you've never been. Welcome, I'm so glad you're here. Oh, by the way, earlier when I mentioned Alex, that's Alex.
Hey.
We were talking about some recording stuff and whatever, and Mitch was like, I can play the drums, I just don't know how to put the effects and everything on.
And I said, oh, you need to meet Alex. And lo and behold, Alex showed up. Yeah, pick a shady spot.
So anyway, as I was saying, so this Heaven When We're Home, this is a song that I heard, and I just, there was something about the lyrics that I could
not let go of, and I said, I have to learn this song. And so one of my trips back to Rwanda, when I could finally start going back there again, this song,
I just played it over and over and over and over and over again to teach it to myself. So Adelphine, who works for me in my house in Rwanda, she heard this song on repeat, but luckily she actually really liked it. So this is for Adelphine and for everybody who needs to find a little place
of heaven when you're home. Don't know what time it is, I've been up way too long and I'm too tired to sleep. I call my mother on the phone. She wasn't home, and now I'm wandering the streets. I've been a fool, I've been cruel to myself. I've been hanging on to nothing. Nothing could be worse than hanging on, and something tells me there must be something better than all this. I've fallen many times in love, and every time it's been with the wrong man. Still I'm out there living, one day at a time, and doing the best I can. Cause we've all made mistakes and seemed to lead us astray, but every time they help to get us where we are today, and that's as good a place as any, and it's probably where we're best off anyway. It's a long and rugged road, and we don't know where it's headed, but we know it's gonna get us where we're going. And when we find where we're looking for, we'll throw these bags and search no more, cause it's gonna feel like heaven when we're home. It's gonna feel like heaven when we're home. There's no such thing as perfect, and if there is, we'll find it when we're good and dead. Trust me, I've been looking, but tonight I think I'll go and take a bath.
Then maybe I'll walk a while and feel the earth beneath me.
They say if you stop looking, it doesn't matter if you find it. And who's to say that even if I did, it's what I'm really looking for. It's a long and rugged road, and we don't know where it's headed, but we know it's gonna get us where we're going. And when we find what we're looking for, we'll drive.
About and explored since last time I saw you is drop D tuning. So we're gonna drop the D, and it's really fun and sounds really cool.
Okay, I got it. Alright. Okay. So
this is another Waylon Jennings tune. Thank you.
to my sister Diane, who's an amazing bird photographer. So, all right, so the last one we're doing in our little drop D tuning set here is a song, Susan Werner, who you may remember from before. She's an amazing singer-songwriter that I just, she's incredible. And she's also from Iowa. Yes.
Born and raised in Iowa, as I was. And
she's got this great album called The Gospel Truth. And she always says she thinks it's the only gospel album written by an agnostic.
And she clearly grew up in the church. I think she grew up Catholic. But this song just is really resonating with me right now, in a time when it feels like there's
so much attacking
going on, and there's so much not listening to one another, and so much
vilifying the other side,
and extremist positions that have no room
for compromise.
And so I give you Heaven So Small.
Excuse me, sir, what did you say? You shout so loud it's hard to tell. You say that I must change my ways, for I am sure you're and I know you damn summertime. One of these moments. After that sleepy, by the way, it wasn't until I moved to the South that I fully understood
that song and like the oppressive heat and that summertime thing. This next one, this is another one. It's actually a Tom Petty song from from what's arguably maybe his best album ever,
Wildflowers, and it's the title track, Wildflowers.
And as I was, but I encountered this song for the first time, because I'm not a huge Tom Petty fan, sorry. But I'm becoming one now. The Waylon Jennings do a rendition of this song, which is the first time I heard it. And then as I started trying to learn more about the song, I found out, oh, this was written by Tom Petty, and written at a time in his life where he was pretty low and pretty, Wildflowers was a pretty introspective album, personal album for him. And this song, Wildflowers, first of all, what is amazing, and I hear this is true, that the lyrics of this song, he literally, in the studio on one take, sang the lyrics, like on the spot. They weren't written down, they weren't necessarily thought of totally ahead. He just went in the studio, and this is where his heart was that day, and this is what came out. And I just think it's a great message.
I was hoping that the Mahdi's would be here. That's the
family that's usually kind of in the back, and they have the four beautiful children. And Esme sang with us last year, and I'm hoping one of the Sundays we'll get Esme back up here with us. But she challenged me to begin to learn
a Jason Mraz tune called Have It All. And I just,
like, I was bound and determined to learn the lyrics as well as Esme had learned them. As I started learning them and thinking about them, I started thinking about, I have, you know, one of my dearest friends from college, her eldest, just graduated from high school and is about ready to go off to college, and thinking about parents who are becoming empty nesters, and just the situations in life. And a lot of times when I'm singing this as well, I'm thinking about like my niece and nephew, and that you want for them to have it all. You want them to have all the experiences, all the kinds of love
there are in the world, and just be out there. But yet at the same time, you're like, oh, but.
So this is to all those people out there who are going through those moments in their lives
right now. May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in being generous, sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrow.
Anything?
You gotta do good trouble.
Oh, we can do Good Trouble.
Yeah.
Well, I've got
Oh, you got it. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Galen can look at this. He hasn't done it in a while. So he's got, you know, like encyclopedic volumes of music up there. So
we're not worried about him.
So I would love to do Good Trouble tonight.
Thank you.
And then maybe we'll close with that. We'll do our other closer, but then we'll really, well, that'll be like our encore.
And then
if there's anything that between now and the July, the August, the September that you remember from Sunday Songs Past that you're really hoping you get to hear this summer, just message me or let me know. I'm
happy to throw those back in there. As well as
if you really love what you're hearing, we love tips. We love monetary appreciation. So on Facebook, if you look in the little description about this Facebook Live, you'll see the Venmo if you'd like to send in a tip or two that way.
And it is on Venmo. It is at Galen-Hunsucker. G-A-L-E-N.
Hyphen, just like it sounds, H-U-N-S-U-C-K-E.
Irish mother, Dutch mom.
and if you're here and you have cash at the end, Galen loves to take cash out of your wallet. So. Right?
With your permission.
Yeah, yeah. We won't fleece you. All right. So, this next one. One that I thought Ray was going to request.
But he didn't.
Actually, believe it or not. And I'm sad that
Brian's not here because this is actually, Brian really loves this song too. This is one I wrote. And
at the time, we decided to put this on this set list. It was just for the reason that I love to sing it. And it's Isabel. And I love any time I can think about my dear friend Isabel. But in particular, I asked prayers for her parents. They're both in the hospital right now, and they're both, her father is already undergoing surgery, her mother undergoes surgery on Tuesday, and so it's just a lot in her world right now, so any wonderful energy you can send her way, she could use it, so this is Isabel.
Your life. When life
What would you do? What if you knew all your dreams would come true? Well, your dreams, they are so much bigger than you. So seize the day.
Debuted at a Beto O'Rourke event back when Beto was running for
Senate last time. Yeah, when he was running for the Senate. And
called Vote Him Out. And this is one of those times, I try not to get political when I'm up here and I'm on the mic, but we are at a time that we have to be reminded that the very essence of our democracy is free and fair elections. And those are not going to stay free and fair if people that believe in that don't get involved in the election process. So I just want to encourage anybody who's ever thought about volunteering at a polling place. I'm actually gonna submit an application to be on the Board of Elections or get involved some other way in the electoral process here in this county. And it is so, so important. And if nothing else, educate yourself about the candidates and get out there and vote. So, here we go, a little vote.
You don't like who's in there, what about you? It's what election day is all about. Thank you.
you got this one? Oh, yeah. It's in there somewhere. It'll find its way out. All right. You need to peek at that. Hang on. Let me do this. Let me do this. We can fix this.
Thank you so much for coming out.
Thank you, Beth.
Thank you.
Hi, Beth.
Hi, Beth.
Yeah.